Alpha Prime is one of those obscure games that most people haven't played. And yeah, we all know how those usually are, right? They either turned out to be hidden gems, or they're steaming piles of shit. Which one is Alpha Prime? Well, let's take a look.
Nice shot. God, move it, move it.
Alpha Prime is a first-person shooter developed by Czech development team Black Element Software. They also made the action-adventure game Shade Wrath of Angels. I remember liking it, but I replayed it recently and it's... not very good. Back to Alpha Prime. The game is not very well known and most people talk negatively about it. So what did I think about it? Well, it may be an unoriginal sci-fi shooter, but I still really like it. It's not any kind of masterpiece, but I already finished it twice, and I had good time each playthrough. Alright, enough of my rambling, let's finally talk about the game. And as always, we'll start with the story. Well, kinda. You play as Arnold Weiss, and you're hired to find missing prospector on old mine asteroid Alpha Prime, hence the title. But in all honesty, I don't really want to say more. The story isn't amazing, but it's gonna keep you invested. And the game is really short, so every small detail I would say would spoil part of the story. It's pretty much a dumb B-movie, but with really distinct characters. Sadly, the game ends with cliffhangers, so yeah, that sucks. The story is also really weirdly presented. Like, there are standard cutscenes, and those are fine, you know, cutscenes where characters stand around or walk around and talk. However, I'm pretty sure that over half of the story is told in these weird static voiceovers. Camera stares at Arnold from behind and he's chatting with someone on radio. I don't know why they did this, but it's stupid and I don't like it.
Didn't count on them helping Warren. If someone here obviously laid mines.
They tried to cut Alpha off, to get rid of witnesses. Maybe they'll destroy it completely.
Now, onto a presentation, which is actually pretty damn good in this game. Character models are okay, environments are nice, there's a lot of detail here, and the music, despite only having few tracks, is a real headbanger. The voice acting, however, is a mixed bag. Main characters and the villain I voiced pretty well. I especially like Arnold's performance. He's a bit of a sarcastic asshole and the voice actor really has fun with it.
This is the first time their ship is in a radio shadow.
So they just flew by and let the Artemis sink below the horizon? They didn't even stop to have a cup of coffee with you. And those green berets sure have no manners.
On the other hand, the side characters are just awful.
Once again, to believe in chemistry for a minute. And don't puke on my boots.
I'm not drunk. It's your stupid swine.
The main attraction is this guy.
Find the safest route for me.
You know, Paolo no like shooting. Morbido. Uno body, due bodies, lots of bodies. Boom, bang, everywhere.
His name is Paolo, and not only he gives one of the worst performances I've ever heard in any video game, but he also talks a lot.
And at me again. Ouch. Ah, they've killed me. I am it. My poor leg, completely dead. They've killed me. I've been shot by them. I will get blood poisoning.
But this is a shooter, and the story in this is as important as a story in porn. So, let's move on to gameplay. Alpha Prime is surprisingly a slow-paced shooter. All the enemies use the same guns as you do, and even on normal you can die really quickly. So if you want to make it, you have to take it slowly, lean around corners, and be sure to run from cover to cover. Enemy AI is definitely not fear AI, but they are aggressive and if they flank you, you can say goodbye to most if not all of your health. Honestly, the game will probably give you some bad first impressions. You have to fight these robots who don't take headshot damage, unlike human enemies. So they're a bit more bullet spongy and can easily kill you. Yeah, that sucks. Thankfully, you spend the game fighting enemy soldiers. And that's where the real fun is, because scoring headshots on these guys is so satisfying. Overall, the shooting feels really good with great looking particle effects and blood effects. Enemies also ragdoll when you kill them, so again, more satisfaction. And yes, I'm one of those people who prefers ragdolls over the preset animations. The arsenal in this game is conventional, but still practical, so let's go through it. Your first weapon is a hammer, which is... What the fuck? Second weapon is pretty decent pistol. It has decent firing rate, accuracy and even damage. I didn't use it much in late game, but it's still a decent backup in case you run out of ammo. Next up is a shotgun, which is sadly not very useful. It's not bad or anything, but the spread makes it way too situational. And as I said, enemies can kill you quickly, so you can't really fuck around with shotgun. The Gatling rifle, on the other hand, is what you're gonna be using most of the game. And yeah, don't mind those spinning barrels. It looks cool, but this is a standard assault rifle, and you have to fire it in short bursts because it only has 28 round magazine. Next is the sniper rifle. Great for headshots from distance, and useful against armored enemies. Ammo, however, is a bit hard to come by and the aiming feels kinda stiff, especially when leaning. The grenades, however, despite being useless in most games, are actually pretty damn good in this one. Next up is the rocket launcher. It's exactly what you would expect, but it's practical and it has pretty cool reload. And finally, we have a flamethrower. It's shit. So yeah, this is your arsenal. You're mostly gonna be shooting enemies in the mining complex, but sometimes you'll get on surface and you'll have to use oxygen dispensers to stay alive. And this is pretty much the game, going throughout the game at mostly good pace and shooting enemies in pretty good combat areas. The game, however, tries to incorporate a vehicle section. It looks good, I'm surprised how large this area actually is, but the buggy controls like shit with overly sensitive turning and sporadic speed. Plus, there is this one part where you have to abandon your buggy, walk across these pipes, just to find another buggy! Yeah, good effort, but it's janky and underdeveloped. Speaking of underdeveloped, there is a hacking. You can hack into cameras, and sometimes you can hack into mines and turrets. That sounds pretty cool, but you'll barely use it, and as I was writing script for this video, I completely forgot about it. Speaking of forgetting something, there is a slow motion. It's pointless. So with everything said, I like this game for what it is. The pacing is good, combat is satisfying, most weapons are fun to use, and the music is great. Plus it's not over long and it's just for 5 euros, so I think it's a good value. If you like shooters, I see no reason not to play this, but be prepared for janky experience. But hey, sometimes we all just need a fun game to blast through, right? Thank you for watching and stay safe.